if you're like me, you'll end up with a load of transformers for a bit of a hoarder. Take it apart, you've got your mains primary, you've got your secondary, on this one it's center tapped, and your red light, your bit rectifier and capacitor. Take it all apart, you end up with something like this. Inside there you've actually got two bobbins. There's a piece of plastic there which supports the two bobbins. They actually slot them in to this bit of plastic before putting the laminations on. If you strip it all down, you can actually take the bobbins apart and end up with a load of separate bobbins. The way to take them apart is with like a Stanley knife. Be very careful because you don't want to slip with this. You can get underneath the first lamination and work your way very gently round. There's a little bit of varnish on this, so it's not too heavy in most cases. Well, if you lift up one of the corners and bend it up slightly, you can then get some pliers on there, and as you notice, it's starting to fall apart already, and start pulling these laminations out. You might need to use some decent pliers or pipe grips to get the first one out, but once you get going, you then work your way down to the level, and as I saw one of the eye laminations has come out, and you just gently ease them. You don't have to bend every one of them, but once you get a move on, they'll actually come out fairly easily. You end up with your primaries and your secondaries like that. If you want to generate a high voltage, normally you get a single transistor transformer and something like a two transistor driver on a 7-tap coil, and you alternate your voltages on the coil, and that will give you a secondary voltage on one of the mains windings. If you stack several windings together, you can increase that secondary voltage by quite a bit. If you imagine you've got 6 volts, 6.6 going in, and 240 volts for each coil coming out, all wired in series, you're getting on for 1,000 volts if you can achieve the correct resonance or frequency, whatever. As I mentioned, the laminations are an E and an I, as they call them in most of the cheaper transformers, and they stack them together like that, and then your other E that way. And you're basically delaminating it. You end up with all these E's and I's everywhere. And what I do, set them up this way. Your first layer will be like that, an E at one end. And you'll find that two of these I's normally is the same width as the centre of that E. And you'll need it. That's all length. You could put 4 bobbins along with a primary. Then your second layer alternates so that that goes on top like that. The way you start this is not to try and feed everything onto the one and feed all your things in. I find the easiest way is to put one of your E's in there. Two of your eyes and stack them in there side by side. Take your other E two more eyes, and so you build it up in that method. You needn't be too neat because you always square it up as you go, keep it held down into the bottom of the coil, and then you build them all the way up, ease and noise, alternately. You'll notice I'm not doing the edges, because once the stack is all together, you can slot them in afterwards to fill up all the gaps. You'll find you might have something sticking out at the end when it's all compressed together. Don't worry too much about that, because that can help with mounting. It's not going to affect the performance of the transformer at all. Nothing to worry about. What you end up with is something like that. You'll notice there's two 40 volt coils there, two there, and then the 606 is in the middle. Always put the mains on one side and the low voltage on the other side, and these are wired in series. You'll find in most cases that they start and finish in the same direction, so you've got no problem with wiring like that. You might want to test it separately by pulsing the primary and see which way you make it moves, but I would just go for that method I've done there and give it a go. And if you don't get the necessary results, you always swap the wires over. As I said, the primary is on the other side. Actually 606 or 909, I think it's on 909. Switched by two power transistors mounted on aluminium heat sinks and powered by a stable mod vibrator with two BC108s and a couple of tantalum B capacitors. Still got to play about with it. This is more a play circuit than anything else, just to test the concept. I'll get about 650 volts AC from the secondary, but I'll say it's not totally tuned right and anything else, so and the coils may not actually match with the primary. I've got a bridge rectifier on there, which I'll connect to a capacitor. I've got no idea of the voltage I'll get off of it, but I'll get a decent spark from a reasonable capacitor. I'll then use my meter on it, as I've already blown up 1 meter trying to set voltages. This one runs up to 12 volts. I might try it on a higher voltage when I get the power supply out. Power supply and battery making up to 24 volts. But I've got a variable voltage on the power supply, so I can ease it up from 12 up towards the 24. Well, that's it. Any more information is actually on the on my Google site. You'll see the link in my description directly to the Morley Bobbin Transformer category. We've done all the transformer. What you'll end up with is a load of laminations. You might say, well, what do I do with them? If you're artistic like me, I suppose, you can create a bit of artwork.